Next news out of Australia. Negative attitudes about Muslims in Australia remain high, survey finds. So yeah, okay, there was a survey that was done. They surveyed about 3,500 people all over Australia, half of which were from written surveys. The other half were from over the phone surveys. They found that over 90% of the respondents said that they felt a sense of belonging to Australia. 85% of the respondents said that they support multiculturalism in Australia. These are high numbers. This is really good. Well, there's a minority, they call it significant minority, but a minority that says that they feel they have negative views about Muslims and rate themselves. So the over the phone, they said about 21% said that they, 21 to 25%, I'm sorry, of those interviewed over the phone said they held negative views about Muslims. But in the written survey, it almost doubled at 40%. So while Australians are for and absolutely want multiculturalism in Australia, they have negative feelings towards Muslims. The only problem that I think everyone needs to keep in mind with any sort of survey, written or over the phone, is how this question was posed.
Okay. How was it posed? Okay, go on. How was it posed?
I don't know.
Oh.
And that's why we need to be careful about these kind of surveys that aren't upfront. I've been trying to find this survey, trying to find links. If somebody does find it, please post it in the comments after the show. That'd be really, really, really helpful so we can see the whole survey and actually see which questions were asked. But as any, like we say about any of the statistics we report on this news, I always want people to be mindful about the source and about why, you know, these numbers could be this way.
Yeah, I don't know if they're actually against Muslims or against Islam. Is it concerned Muslim or Islam? And I can't judge unless I see how the question, what was the question and how was it asked. And you know, there's a whole bunch of problem, right? Because to a lot of people answering the question, sometimes they can't see the difference between being anti-Islam or anti-Muslim. But also sometimes even the people that are doing the poll, some seem to confuse the two. And, you know, try to suggest an anti-Islam position actually means an anti-Muslim position. But to me, we did another story a while back ago about Australia and it's another survey, which seemed to suggest that, you know, Australians were mostly concerned about Islam, but they're not anti-people, you know, anti-foreigners or anti-immigrants. To me, that might suggest that their concern is not the Muslims themselves, but the ideas that they're bringing. You know what I mean? So to me, it seems like the concern is the idea, and I hope that is true. I don't know if that's true because I don't know how the question was posed, and I don't think anybody that hasn't seen the way the question was posed should be able to make that judgment. So I think the easiest position and the most logical position to have is that we don't know what this really means, right?
Right.
Right. Shupam, do you agree with that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So again, a lot of people are like, well, how could you be against Islam but not against Muslims? Muslims are the people that are believing in Islam, and they spread Islam, and they're bringing that disease with them. I mean, the answer is easy. The same way we're against cancer but not against the cancer patient, right? We keep saying that. And again, there is no way for you to fight against an idea if you want to fight against the, you know, directly against the people, because usually, as we see, when you attack the people, that doesn't hurt the idea, that actually helps the spread of the idea, right? Religions feed on victimization. And actually, if you even stop the movement or rights of, you know, people, or if you want to be aggressive against them, you know, that doesn't stop the spread of ideas. Ideas doesn't need bodies. People don't physically have to move around for ideas to spread, right? So ideas could spread very easily without even the people carrying them. In fact, we have shown time and time and again, based on the strategies that we use and what has worked best for us, is that the more friendly and accepting you are of the people, the easier it is for you to fight the toxic ideas that they hold. So that's why we're saying, you know, is, you know, even if, you know, from a moral perspective, it's obvious that you should be not against Muslims, but you should be against Islam. But even if that's not your concern, even if you don't care much about morality and you just want to destroy Islam, strategically as well, strategically it makes also more sense to be friendly towards Muslims and accept them and befriend them and try to get involved them in your community. Strategically, that is also the best way to fight Islam. So even if you want to, even like, yeah, that's idealistic. No, practically, if you want to end Islam, you can't be like pro-Muslim. No, it's not idealistic. Actually, practically, that also works a bit. That's the best thing to do. Cody is saying, if people still believe religion is the path to peace, we're so screwed. Sure, yeah. Michael is saying, good, a negative attitude towards all religions is a healthy thing to have. Well, Michael, you didn't read the title because it says Muslims. Yeah, I agree. A healthy attitude, a negative attitude towards religions, all religions, not against religious people. This is the people confusing the, you know, the disease with the patient. It's so something so simple and something that we need to keep talking about. I know we're tired of talking about it because it's been saying it forever, but given it seems like we need to keep doing it because so many people still don't get it.
Right. Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we are doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.